Hi, I'm Dave from Tomas Jacks, and today I've got a guest with me.
I am Matt, and I am also from Tomas Jacks.
Look at that, double header. Right, today we are talking about the brand new Mile 2 from Pixfra. It's a thermal camera, thermal monocular, whatever you want to call it, and there's something quite special with this, not least its entry price level, which is under 400 quid, but there are nine different options you've got with this, three different sensor sizes, six different lenses.
Yeah.
Have I got that right? Matt's the expert, he
Maybe.
Knows this stuff.
Sounds about right.
Sounds like I almost don't know what I'm talking about. But Matt, being the product expert, is gonna talk us through some of what is brilliant about this new camera. Matt, I haven't seen anything else like this on the market, shape-wise, design-wise. Feels quite different. Tell me something about the design that you like or that you've spotted.
So, I mean, straight away, it's in your face. It's so small. It's really compact. The fact that it can fit in your back pocket, your side pocket, your top pocket, it fits in your hand really nicely. It's such good performance in such a small unit. And I know for a lot of people, in lots of different applications, they have tons of kit that they carry around all the time. So why do you want something else that's big, bulky, and weighs you down when you can get something that gives you the performance?
Stick it in a little shoulder pocket or something like that.
Anyway, literally, it's so small.
Brilliant.
And so compact. So
yeah,
don't get me wrong, the design's really nice in terms of button alignment, ease of use with lens cap, focusable mechanisms on both ends, so diopter focus and objective focus. Some of the more entry-level ones are fixed focus on the front,
right,
but we can talk about that.
Yep.
Down to little features, like you probably don't necessarily always think about, but the way that they've thought about this textured side on the back, on both sides, so whether you're a right or a left-handed user, that grips really nicely for your thumb, so you've got full control of the unit. That then also fits really nicely with the three-finger button alignment for your menuing system, your magnification, and your record. And one that I'm a little bit embarrassed to say, to be honest, Dave, but at the same time is a really nice, cool feature, is the on button. It definitely didn't take me half an hour to find this on button when they first came in. But the on button is actually just on the side there next to the product name. And again, really slender, really slick, well hidden, to be honest, but again, just doesn't get in the way. You're not likely to tap it or bump it accidentally. Just well thought through, I think, is the manufacturing of this.
That three button configuration, that's quite different. Normally there's four buttons on a lot of products, but three makes that more usable. That turning it on or putting it on standby mode, that's kind of not that frequent a use button compared to everything else, so that kind of makes a lot of sense to have that on the side.
Yeah, definitely, and it just looks neat. It looks really neat.
Yeah.
And again, we buy these, or people buy these devices because they do a job.
Yeah.
But at the same time, if they can look pretty whilst doing it, then great.
And that's an interesting point, because thermal cameras do a job.
Yeah.
And because we have got something that is genuinely entry level that makes thermal cameras accessible to a whole new audience here, what is the job that you need a thermal camera for?
So, look, you can use thermal for, I mean, there's probably 25, 50 different applications.
Right.
The list is never ending, I would have thought. But the parameters are that it spots heat radiation in all different types of conditions.
Right.
So whether you're in the day, whether you're in the dark, it just reads heat. Whether you're looking at buildings or whether you're looking at animals, objects, vehicles, anything that you're looking at,
right,
as long as there's a contrast in one temperature to another, these will pick up that contrast, build you an image onto the display so you can look at it. So from as simple as going out looking for wildlife, birds in the trees, or I don't know, you take your dog for a walk and your dog goes missing and you just want to be able to find your dog, or security application where security people are looking after boat yards or shipping containers. I mean, forever. There's so many applications. Hunters, shooters, literally anybody could use these.
And at the other end, wildlife enthusiasts, ecologists,
yeah,
a lot of people who've got an interest in wildlife will now be starting to use thermal cameras to help them to detect where that animal is, where that bird is, to know where to point their camera, where to point their binoculars, where to go to get closer to it, to get a better look at it.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. It's a growing market for sure. At the end of the day, these products reduce disturbance and reduce time in the field. That's the biggest way I ever describe them in terms of their application, their uses.
Yeah.
Yes, you can go out and you can try and go wildlife spotting with your standard binoculars and be out for hours on end and not see what you want to see.
Yeah.
But if you take one of these, you can detect the heat source that you're looking at, and then you can swap to your bins to be able to identify what you're looking at.
Right, so we've got 9 different options.
Yeah.
If we start at the bottom end of the range here, and that would get us the, what's this one? This is the Mile.
So that specific one you're looking at there is an M215.
Right, so what do you get at entry level?
Yeah, so the base product, the real entry level product, has got the same size sensor as what's in that, but operates with a smaller lens.
Right.
So we start from a Mile 2, 7mm, so it's called an M207.
Right.
That offers a 256 by 192 sensor, which is very, very good for the money.
That's not the smallest sensor you get in the market. So at an entry level, you're getting a sort of a mid-range, a decent-sized sensor.
Yeah, 100%. So yeah, comparable. I mean, there have been products on the market ranging from £300 to £400 before, but you're looking at sort of 160 by 120 sensors. This offering a 256 by 192 sensor, it's a lot bigger.
That's a lot more pixels to capture more information and give you a better quality image.
Definitely.
Okay, right. So you get a 256.
By 192 sensor.
By 192 sensor. What else are you getting at that entry level?
Obviously, you're getting the same compact shape, design, form that you get throughout all the others, all the accessories in the box. You get a nice little carry pouch, so really nice to use. You can obviously strap that onto maybe your belt. You get a really nice neck strap as well, which is good. You get variations of eye cups, which we can talk about in an application later.
Yep.
Obviously your cable. In terms of what you get through the device, you get a very good priced sensor for the price of the product.
I would imagine that's sort of a fairly close quarter work, looking at what's in the field in front of you, what's on the other side of the other end of the street that you might be in. This isn't for long range detection, like several hundred meters. This is what?
Yeah, close quarters.
Sub 200.
Yeah, that's 100,
100, 200 meters, something like that.
That's how I would.
If you just need to know that there's something there, this will do it.
Yeah, 100%. I think that's you're right, close quarters. There's bigger sensors that you can spend more money on to get bigger detection at bigger ranges. But with the entry level model, so it will be a 7mm, a 10mm, a 15mm, and then also a 15mm with a manual focus.
Right.
So those first three that we spoke about, close quarters, 150 meters down.
Wide angle, I would guess, for those smaller lenses. And as you're going up the range, you're getting narrower field of view, but
bigger
better
detection.
Magnification.
Yeah, definitely.
Right. Better base mag.
Yeah.
Okay, brilliant. Okay. And so the price starts at sub 400 and goes up to what at the top end of the range?
So the top spec unit is this device that we've got here. So that's £1,259 for a 640 512 resolution sensor.
Okay, so a really good sensor. That's a really big sensor.
Yeah, 100%.
Not the biggest, but that's a big sensor
for the money.
For the money and a device that's that
compact.
That compact. Brilliant.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
Obviously, we touched on slightly, as you go up in the range and you spend more money, instead of having as the entry level price points from sort of £570 downwards, starting from 640 upwards to the 1250 mark, they are all focusable mechanisms, so objective focus. So that means that you can use it at bigger distances and you can focus at 10 yards as well as you could focus at 150 yards or even further, for example.
Okay.
This does make a big difference in terms of getting better detail at distance.
Brilliant. Okay, that's good. Now, we talked about two components that are crucial to getting a decent quality image from any thermal camera, and that's the lens and the sensor.
Correct. Yeah.
Is there anything else within this that make it good?
Yeah, so
better.
I think one of the biggest things for me, especially for the sort of entry level price points, is is the display size.
Right.
So again, one of the negatives that we found over sort of the market in the last few years is everything that is priced in at a very competitive price for sort of recreational users or entry level users or for people that just want to have a thermal for on a budget is that there has to be sacrifices made in the manufacturing to keep the cost down.
Okay.
So some of the easiest ways to obviously sacrifice that is inserting the bits where they don't necessarily deem them as important. I personally think the display size is really important. It really frustrates me looking through sort of more affordable units or cheaper units where you're almost looking for the screen. Like it's like a postage stamp in the device. And you almost like put your eye against it and you're looking for it.
Okay.
These have got an 800 by 600 display. So the screen is massive. So as soon as you put your eye up against it, you aren't looking for the screen. The screen's in your face and it looks really immersive. So it's really nice to look through.
Okay, and that's across the whole range. Has got 800.
Yeah, by 600.
By 600.
So you look at something that's £399.
AMOLED.
Yeah, AMOLED
screens. Right, okay.
Yeah.
So good in all weathers.
Yeah.
That's really good. Okay. Was there anything else in terms of the either the design of it or the usability of it that struck your attention?
So, I mean, what you tend to find, again, like we were speaking about earlier, is when sort of things come to market, they might not be they might not have all the vast settings and controls, and the software is quite a big thing that we always speak about, because at the end of the day, every different condition or different conditions within the weather can make huge difference on the performance. You take the unit out one night and you don't change any settings to the second night, the picture looks completely different.
Right.
What these offer is these offer such a large range of settings that you can be able to get the optimal picture in the conditions that you're in.
So brightness?
Brightness.
Contrast.
Sharpness.
Okay.
Which is quite a nice little feature to be able to just get a little bit of extra recognition detail.
I've noticed they've also got a little hot point indicator, so it'll track and put a little a little cross over the hottest point on the screen, which is quite good if you're if say you're watching it on your phone, because these all connect to your phone as well.
Yep.
And you might have your attention on something else as well while you're doing this, it'll ping up a little cross on the screen and it'll track it across the screen as that object moves.
Yeah.
That's quite useful. So there's lots of really nice features in there. The thing that I find really important is how user-friendly these things are, because when I go out in the field, and quite often I'm going out for the first time with a brand new device, and so I'm kind of replicating that new user experience for the videos that I'm doing. Some units are easier and more user-friendly than others. How have you found these Pixfra Mile 2s?
They're really simple to use. So in terms of the button configuration, obviously that makes a big difference.
Yeah.
So the main thing that people do tend to sort of mess around with, depending on the conditions, it can be color palettes.
Okay.
That can be for multiple different reasons. One of the biggest reasons why people like to change color palettes is sort of eye strain. Certain color palettes for certain users is a lot easier on their eye.
Mm.
So this central button is literally just a one tap each time, and that will flick through the different color palettes.
And it toggles through all the way around until you get back to
where you started.
So okay,
you've got white hot, red hot, you've actually got green hot, which not many devices actually use, which I find quite nice. Again, then easy use of magnification, you just up through the cycle and then back down.
Right.
Video and record, again, long press for video, single press for still. When you're using the menu button as well, again, it's really simple. It's just a long press for the menu, up and down to go to which one you want to, menu to go through the stages or increase the brightness or contrast, and then you press the power button to come back out of it. It's so simple.
Brilliant.
And that's a massive thing for our users, because at the end of the day, you don't want to have to be messing around with units and trying to work out how they work. You kind of want them to just sort of be easy operation.
And with that one, if you are a newbie, you don't even have to worry about focus.
No,
it's
exactly.
Turn it on and go.
Yeah, and that's it.
That's brilliant. Okay, right. So we will be doing videos of each individual unit with footage through the lens of each one of these. So we'll talk about each one individually in more detail. So don't forget to subscribe if you want to see those videos coming up in the near future. But in the meantime, to find out more about the Mile 2, then visit tj-focus.co.uk. So that's the new product. There's nothing else you wanted to add before we close here?
I mean, there's nothing really specific that I want to sort of add to it. I just, from being able to see these products firsthand.
And give people something. For those people that have stayed tuned right to the end of the video, yeah. Give them another little nugget. Is there must be something else that we've forgotten?
Realistically, in terms of the product and how special it is.
It's got a nice tripod mount.
A nice tripod mount, which can be used in different applications again.
I've thought of something. I've thought of that Easter egg. Right, okay. If you connect this to your phone,
yes.
Not only will it connect at really quite a decent range, like 30 feet or something, yeah, I've had it too, but you can connect multiple
devices.
Phones. So if you had like a school group or something like that, you can connect four different screens to it.
Correct, yeah.
Simultaneously, four different people as well as the user. Yep. You've got five people looking at the same thermal image at once.
Yeah, yeah. That's
how good is that? No one else is doing that.
It's a pretty nifty feature. Yeah. I don't know anything else that does that. There might be.
Yeah.
But like you said, distances. We've had this tested out here, didn't we?
Yeah.
50, 60 meters.
Yeah.
There's still functionality. Crazy. Yeah.
That's brilliant. Excellent. Right. Yeah. So I think we should probably wrap it up there. Yeah. So I'm Dave from Tomas Jacks.
And I'm Matt.
That's Matt. Thanks very much for watching.